of that. Now, last week, Arthur said this next celeb was 100% committed to disco. So this week, he's moved as far away from disco as you could possibly get, because that's what having a two-year-old does to your head. Dancing the Paso Doble, it's Kevin McGahern and Laura Nolan.
So I am dedicating my dance to my daughter, Wallace. I've got two kids. Wallace turned two there at Christmas, and Jessie's 3 months old. So Wallace loves music, loves dancing. She likes stuff with a really heavy beat. If she really likes a song, she goes down on her hands and knees and puts her bum in the air and sort of shakes it about a bit, which is a move I have not learned yet.
What song have you chosen for a dedicated dance?
She has two favourite songs. Number one is Baby Shark. I'm not going to dance to that.
It's not really a danceable
song. It's not a dancey song. No. And number two is Smells Like Teen Spirit by Nirvana.
Ooh, that's a good song.
Yeah, she's a headbanger.
The Paso Doble, I think, would be a perfect fit for that song.
This one's for you, Wallace. And Jesse, if you can understand. He's too small.
Kevin is actually very good at the Paso, but I really need him to believe in himself. I think he's overthinking some of the parts of the routine.
Five, six. All the way around.
Hey!
So to pick up Kevin's spirits, Wallace, Jesse, and Siobhan came in to surprise him in rehearsals.
Hi!
And I think it worked.
One, two, three, and four.
Every week is a different challenge. Yeah, it's not getting any easier. So it was nice to have them come in, give me a bit of a perk.
Wallace, this weekend, we're dancing for you, baby. It's all for you. You better appreciate it. Do you appreciate it?
Yeah!
Dancing the Paso Doble, Kevin McGahern and Laura Nolan.
My friend, bringing the rock and roll to the ballroom, am I right? Oh, bit disappointed you didn't do Wallace's move with the bum in the air.
Yeah.
Next week, put it in.
Baby Shark.
Yeah, absolutely.
We'll do it for Baby Shark.
Next week. Arthur.
Kevin, what a song to do Paso Doble to. Yeah. I mean, wow!
Yeah.
But I have to say, I was a little bit disappointed because I wanted to see Paso Doble to Baby Shark. But no, I have to say, jokes apart, the opening, your walks, knee walks were so powerful. The intensity, you were in it to win it. You were so strong. Yeah. You brought the daddy moves into Paso Doble, and I loved it. Bravo, daddy. Bravo.
Bravo.
Thank you, brother, daddy.
The first thing I'd say is something you really need to be careful about.
and it's just watch it on the hairspray. Look what happened to me. You need to be careful with that. I think the energy in this was really, really nice, and I think also what you captured was the body shaping really, really well, particularly on the twist turns in that corner over there. That really presented Laura fabulously, and we've mentioned that a few times with different Paso Dobles through the season. You did that very, very well. A little bit more articulation of the hands. The hands are just a bit placed, but they're getting better. But this dance particularly calls for that. A bit more athleticism on the jump. It was a bit dad dancing over there. But in terms of a paso doble, I might not be completely in nirvana yet, but I liked it.
Oh, we liked it. Bit more. We just want more. OK, Lorraine.
The opening for me was slow but full of paso doble steps, and I could feel it. It was all building up to this crescendo of music, and then we double dosed on the intensity, and it was like this duel between you. There was the press lines, there was the flick, there was that lovely spinning onto the knees. I mean, I was thinking, oh my God, how are you going to top this? And you did. You went for that finale. It's the leg, the dragging, the turning, and what a finish that was. But the only thing is now, Kevin, your daughter Wallace will want to do that drag every single day. Yeah. So get ready. Yeah. Well, yeah. Done. Well, done. Well done. Kevin and Laura, everyone!
A bit of dad dancing on the jump.
Yeah, that happens here. You have a child and suddenly you dance like a big old fat man.
Tell me this, is Wallace rocking out at home or is she tucked up in bed?
No, she's definitely a night owl, like me and her mammy. So she's definitely watching at home. Hello, Wallace.
There she is. Paso's all about character and power and strength. Yes. Was it hard to get into that character this weekend?
What do you think, Laura?
I don't think he struggled at all. He's an actor, not only a comedian, so I really just gave him a character to play, and I think that really helped. I think this week he was overthinking at the beginning because he wanted to make Wallace proud and do this performance justice, and I definitely think you did that. He nailed it, and I'm so proud of you. Well done.
Beautiful. Sorry, did I spot that your kids have the blue version of the iconic red Adidas tracksuit from week one?
Yeah, so that they actually had to perform me. I'm copying their style.
Gotcha.
Our friend Linda got us those tracksuits.
Fabulous.
For the kids, and then I was like, I like them, I'm going to get one for myself.
Lovely. You need to bring it back, we haven't seen
it
since.
I need to get one out as well.
Yeah. Laura, does Kevin deserve immunity next week, do you think?
I definitely think he does. He's worked so hard. His characterisation, his musicality and his timing every week, he's brought it. He's been consistent from the beginning to now, and I definitely think that he deserves it.
She knows what she's talking about.
Yeah, she definitely does.
She's a professional dancer. Yeah.
The scores are in.
The judges have their scores. Brian Redland.
8.
Yay! Wayne Barrett.
8.
Yay! Arthur Gouin-Lian.
8.
Yay! That is a total of 24. Kevin's highest score of the series so far, but that is only the judge's opinion. Your vote can also help your favourite couple with immunity from next week's dance-off. So when the lines open, if you want to vote for Kevin and Laura, you can call 1513-71-7104 or text Kevin to 53125. Make some noise for Kevin and Laura.
We have another break to take now, but when we come back, there's no place like home for the Derry Girl. First, how would you fancy it?